Welcome back, everybody. We are stretching your dollar this morning. Registered dietitian Anessa Chumley is joining me with examples of some superfoods that will stretch your budget, but not your waistline. And she's back. Last time we saw Anessa, she was pregnant.
Yep,
and now
right.
I want you to meet her little girl really quickly, okay? Tell us who is this?
Baby Anaya Chumley.
She's 12 weeks old.
Yeah.
So it's so nice to have you back. I saw that picture and I said, oh, you guys, we have to show cute baby pictures.
Oh, my husband's going to kill me.
You look good too. Okay, let's talk about why you're here though today.
Yes.
Trying to help us save some money.
Yeah, so many people throw out the health food when they're on a tight budget. I'm begging Hoosiers not to turn to the processed foods. What we've got to remember is your health is your greatest wealth.
Okay.
And you don't want to get heart disease or something from eating a bunch of junk food. That's going to be a greater expense.
But we're hearing that, like you said, more and more because it is. It's cheaper to do that a lot of
times. It seems like it
is. But not necessarily?
Not necessarily. So stretch foods to me have to give you the most bang for your buck.
Okay.
They have to be nutrient dense. They have to stay on the shelf for a long shelf life.
Okay.
And then you can add them to almost any recipe
to stretch them out.
This is frozen veggies. Any kind of frozen veggies, they're going to be about 25 cents for one cup.
Well,
they're almost just as nutritious as fresh because a lot of fresh produce, you know, can go bad in the refrigerator quickly.
And you're putting these in different things?
Anything. You can put them in soups, stews, stir fries, casseroles.
Okay.
Love them. Next is canned, and let's focus on the canned tomatoes because, you know, you get a nice, juicy, fresh tomato in the winter. You cut into it, it's white and tastes gross. Canned tomatoes are never going to do that to you. They're even more nutritious than fresh. They're super high in lycopene.
Okay, that's a good to know that better than fresh.
Oh, they are. Because the
lycopene
is condensed.
Okay.
Yep, you do. The next thing we're going to look at is dried. And for this, I chose Barilla pasta. It's whole grain. Mm-hmm. And so it's going to have about the two things that I like to increase, which are protein and fiber, about 10 grams of protein and about 5 grams of fiber.
Because you don't typically think of a lot of protein being in pasta.
No, you don't. And that you can add any, you can make it cold, hot, add any kind of meat, veggies to it, bulk it up, and stretch it out.
Okay.
This next one.
Is this your favorite?
It is my favorite because nobody knows about it. It's the ultimate Mac Daddy super secret stretch food.
It's the Mac Daddy stretch food, everybody. Where do you get it?
It's textured vegetable protein. You can get it at certain stores in Bob's Red Mill. You're going to look for that. What it is, and you can get it at Whole Foods in bulk. Super cheap. It's defatted, dehydrated soy flour.
Okay.
So what, it's super high in protein and fiber. It's what they added to school lunch meat in the 70s to bulk it up and stretch it out. You can.
Does it taste gross? That's what people want to know.
See, it's a chameleon food. So you can add it to whatever you want.
What do you have working here?
This is almost going to be like a chili.
So it smells good.
You add it. We're going to add about a half cup or so.
Okay.
And you keep stirring it around, and it's going to absorb the flavors around it. And it'll, as you stir, it's going to kind of absorb everything and just bulk up. Now, you could put ground beef in there and literally double for your family for just cents.
Wow.
It's amazing. I serve
textured
this to people.
Textured vegetable protein.
Nobody knows that they're not eating ground beef.
They don't even know that it's in there.
It's delicious.
All right. Well, we're going to try it. And again, it's not very expensive.
No, it's not very expensive at all. High in protein and fiber and great for you.
That smells good. All right.
Oh, it's good. Okay. The final thing we want to do is what I call kitchen sink recipes. All of these things you can throw in just about anything. So this is going to be a casserole.
Okay.
What you're going to do, a kitchen sink recipe.
Throw it in?
Yep. Throw some veggies in. And I'm going to throw some chicken in.
What was in here originally? What was done in
there? There was two cans of low-fat Campbell's soup, and then I use plain yogurt instead of sour cream.
Vegetables.
Mix that around. Yeah, you can mix that around.
The chicken,
and we'll
did
throw
you say?
It. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Chicken and
gonna put
any
it in
kind
here?
Of vegetables. You don't even have to thaw your frozen veggies.
That's, you don't?
No, you could just throw them on in there.
Gosh, it looks good. Okay.
And anything from the pantry, freezer, anything can go into kitchen sink recipes. Then we'll spread it around.
You do that for me.
Okay. And then you can top it with any kind of, if you've got bread laying around, toast it. And then crumble it up, or you can use Fiber One, which is my favorite topping.
Fiber One?
Yes, you can just puree this down to nothing.
Are you
nothing.
Kidding me? You take your box of cereal?
Yes. So if you've got that laying out in the pantry, use that.
Yeah, and you put it on the top there?
Use any kind of nuts, any kind of cheese, whatever you've got laying around. Because if it goes down the garbage disposal, it's like you're throwing money down the garbage disposal. So you want to use everything up in your kitchen, pantry, freezer, into kitchen sink recipes.
No, I've
stretch
never, ever, ever, ever heard of this.
It's
Anessa
great.
Chumley, there's the information. She can help you with whatever you need to know. Fox59.com, so nice to have you back.
Thanks, good to be here.
And congratulations becoming a mom. Right now, we're going to get you updated on the roadways. Good morning, Jill.
Good morning, Angela. Been a pretty easy commute. Kind of a weird problem on the south side, 65 southbound, between about 465 and Southport. Should be clear by now, but Hoosier helpers, you might